Brought to you by Applicos. High quality audio makes our lives better. Whether at work or at play, many of us derive great pleasure from music, movies, and audiobooks. To ensure that audio devices produce high quality sound that is pleasurable to listen to, every analog or mixed signal device in the audio path must be tested to ensure high quality output. To test analog quality, we need to use a tester such as the Audio Precision APX585 or the Applicos ATX7006, which comes with the Graphical Wave Analyzer and GUI WYSIWYG instrument setup panel right on your PC's desktop. To show how we can test audio quality using such a tester, we will test an analog device's AD7671 16-bit analog-to-digital converter. Normally, analog-to-digital converters are tested by driving one or more linear ramps into the input while the digital output is captured and mathematically analyzed to verify linearity. This method provides us an immense amount of information about how the device will perform either in an instrument application or in an audio application. However, most test engineers prefer to employ the time-tested audio testing techniques documented in this book. Inside on page 29, this book talks about testing linearity by measuring harmonic distortion. Total harmonic distortion, or THD, is a proxy for testing linearity because non-linearities cause a sine wave to be distorted and produce harmonics.
Harmonics corrupt the sound of the music.
It helps to understand that the only difference between the sound of a clarinet and the sound of a trumpet is the set of harmonics produced by each. Both instruments produce the same tones, but differ by which harmonics are added. If the music player alters the harmonic content, it will muddle the sound and hide the nuances that make music a joy to listen to. The book tells us how to test total harmonic distortion and what device faults cause which harmonics, harmonics of course being multiples of the test tone. According to the book, quote, "non-linearities which are not symmetrical around zero produce dominantly even harmonics," unquote. And quote, "non-linearities which are symmetrical around zero produce dominantly odd harmonics," unquote. We can test these two statements using the Applicos AWG20 20-bit arbitrary waveform generator, which has four more bits than the 16-bit CD quality AD7671 we are demonstrating. Using the Applicos GUI, we change the setup from four ramps to a sine with 9 cycles and a peak of 4.5 volts, being certain not to exceed the 5-volt peak limit of the AD7671. We preview the differential waveform to make sure it meets our requirements. Then we drive it into the device and use the Applicos DIO module to capture the digital output. The Applicos displays the digital output as a waveform, and through the magic of signal processing, you can hear it. When we look at the plot closely, we can see that the top of the wave is less than hexadecimal FFFF, and the bottom is greater than 0000, which means that the source waveform did not clip in the device. Now we click the FFT button up top, and we get the spectrum of the captured wave. Because we captured 9 cycles of the sine wave, we see the signal in bin 9 of the spectrum. We can see what look like some very tiny harmonics, which would have some small impact on the THD numbers. When we do an FFT on the Applicos Wave Analyzer, we also get all the statistics, such as signal to noise, effective number of bits, and of course, total harmonic distortion and the amplitude of each harmonic. Here we can see our THD is right around minus 100 dB, which is very good for a device like this. Again, zooming in, we can see that all the harmonics are below minus 100 dB. On the Wave Analyzer, you get both the numerical results and the graphical results to make sense of this massive amount of data. Now let's test the statements made in the book on page 29. Non-linearities which are not symmetrical around zero produce dominantly even harmonics. To test this, we can go to the Applicos AWG20 setup panel and change the DC offset of the waveform going to the device under test. We add 1 volt to the summing node on the output of the AWG. This will cause the input of the device to go half a volt above the input range of the ADC, causing the signal to clip. Note that the software set the input offset from 1.0 volts to 0.999996 volts. The GUI takes your input, programs the hardware, and then reports back via the GUI what the actual value will be given the resolution of the hardware. In other words, the GUI does not ever lie to you. Now we hit the start button, sending the waveform to the DUT. Notice that it changes to an abort button in case you accidentally ask for a million samples at a 1 Hz rate, or something crazy like that. You get a second abort button in the middle of the GUI too. The device under test converts the sine wave to digital, and the digital I/O module captures the digital output, decodes the data stream, and presents the waveform to the wave analyzer. And here is the sound. much harsher than the pure, unclipped tone we heard before. Look closely. You can now see that the sine wave has been clipped at the top at a value of hex FFFF. This means that adding the 1 volt offset had the desired effect and clipped the waveform. Now we hit the FFT button on the wave analyzer and wow, look at all those harmonics. Let's zoom in and get a better look to see which harmonics we got by clipping the top of the waveform. On the far left, we can see the DC offset in bin 0. That's the DC offset that we added. Next, we see the fundamental tone in bin 9. Because we had 9 cycles of the sine wave, we get our fundamental amplitude in bin 9. And that was because we programmed the number of periods to 9 on the AWG setup GUI. Here we can see the harmonics created by the asymmetrical clipping. It's clear that we have the second harmonic in bin 18, the third harmonic in bin 27, the fourth harmonic in bin 36, and so on. But wait, the book told us that non-linearities which are not symmetrical around 0 produce dominantly even harmonics. But the data says that clipping the top of the waveform produced odd and even harmonics. Is it possible that the Bible of audio testing is wrong? Let's see what happens when we clip the bottom of the waveform by subtracting 1 volt from the output of the AWG20. Now we hit the start button again, sending the waveform to the ADC, while a pair of nice big abort buttons wait for us just in case we set up something wrong. The device under test converts the sine wave to digital, and the digital I/O module captures the digital output, decodes the data stream, and presents the waveform to the wave analyzer. This tone sounds the same as the last one, so it appears that clipping the top or bottom of a sine wave has the same effect on the sound compared to the original unclipped tone. Look closely. You can now see that the sine wave has been clipped at the bottom at a value of hex 0000. This means that subtracting 1 volt from the sine wave had the desired effect and clipped the waveform. Again, we hit the FFT button on the wave analyzer and we can see the harmonics created by the clipping. We zoom in and once again we see the same pattern we saw when we clipped the top of the waveform. It's also worth noting that the DC offset in bin 0 shows up as a positive value in this plot, despite the fact that we actually added a negative 1 volt to the waveform. The reason is simple. This is a magnitude plot. The fact that the offset is negative is reflected in a phase plot, which we are not displaying here. But the problem remains. Clipping the bottom of the sine wave resulted in both odd and even harmonics, despite what they said in the industry Bible. So let's toss the Bible and make a definitive statement. Non-linearities, which are not symmetrical around 0, produce both odd and even harmonics. So now it would be prudent to test the other statement on this topic on page 29, that non-linearities which are symmetrical around 0 produce dominantly odd harmonics. So let's test that statement by reprogramming the AWG20 to a 0 volt offset and crank up the peak amplitude of the sine wave to 5.5 volts. Notice that this setting causes the AWG20 to issue the warning clip in red because we exceeded the 5.12 volt peak in our programming. But this won't hurt the tester. And it does not prevent us from doing it, allowing us to test symmetrical clipping. The fact that the AWG20 clips is not important. The AD7671 will clip at 5.0 volts, well before the AWG20 clips at 5.12 volts. Now we hit the start button, again sending the waveform to the ADC. The AD7671 converts the sine wave to digital and the Aplicos digital I/O module captures the digital output, decodes the data stream, and presents the waveform to the wave analyzer. Here's what it sounds like. It sounds much different from the pure tone. Look closely. You can now see that the sine wave has been clipped at both the top at hex FFFF and at the bottom at a value of hex 0000. This means that overdriving the input had the desired effect and clipped the waveform on both the top and bottom. We click the FFT button and now we see a lot of harmonics, but note the difference. As we zoom in, we can see the odd harmonics seem to be taller than the even harmonics. Let's go back to the time domain data and look at how the waveform clipped. Setting the cursors on the edges of the clipped peak, we can see that 125 sample points went above the value of FFFF. We do the same to the bottom of the captured time domain data and note that 123 sample points went below hex 0000. That means that the DUT has a positive offset, and we can compensate for that with the Aplicos AWG20 setup GUI by typing or clicking on the arrows to give us a negative offset, say 1 millivolt. We hit the start button, the waveform goes to the DUT, we capture the digital output, do an FFT, and note that the even harmonics are significantly lower than with no offset. So let's add more negative DC offset. Hit the start button, send the wave to the DUT, capture the output in the DIO, and process again. We zoom into the spectrum and notice that the even-numbered harmonics are significantly smaller than before. We are clearly on the right track, so let's push the DC offset even lower, this time to almost 5 millivolts below zero. Again, we hit the start and look at the resulting spectrum. But suddenly, the even-numbered harmonics are higher than they were before. Clearly, we went too low. So let's try the point halfway between the two settings we used last, just about minus 4 millivolts. We hit the start button, send the waves to the DUT, capture the output into the DIO, and process again. We zoom into the spectrum and notice that the even harmonics are almost non-existent. The odd harmonics dominate this waveform, and the even harmonics are so far down in the noise floor they would be invisible to all but the most accurate instrument. This data disputes their statement that symmetrical clipping yields mostly odd harmonics, probably because they didn't have the accuracy we have today. But now with sub-millivolt control just a mouse click away, we can learn the very depths of this device. The data says that symmetrical clipping creates only odd harmonics. Remember, the Bible of audio testing says non-linearities which are symmetrical around zero produce dominantly odd harmonics. We dispute that statement. We say non-linearities which are symmetrical around zero produce only odd harmonics. Symmetrical clipping will produce no even harmonics if you use an accurate enough instrument. And remember that minus 4 millivolts that gave us this excellent result? Do you know we've seen this number already? Remember when we tested the linearity of this DUT using 4 ramps? We clicked the button for best fit linearity and we got a ton of statistics. Two of those statistics would have told us the offset voltage that would result in absolutely symmetrical clipping, resulting in no even harmonics and a slew of odd harmonics. That was mid-scale error in LSBs times the LSB weight, which comes out to minus 4 millivolts. This is almost exactly the same value we used to empirically prove, using successive approximation, the mid-level offset that would result in the lowest even harmonic content for a symmetrically clipping wave. Now we can go back to the engineer and let him know that he's got a 4 millivolt offset somewhere in his design. The audio testing Bible has yet another false statement that many engineers still believe. On page 73, when talking about the fast Fourier transform, it says, as in any sampled process, the maximum upper's frequency limit is 1/2 the sample rate. Bunk! I have been fighting this misconception longer than this book has been on the shelves, and I created a video to debunk it and show how you can use aliasing to see beyond the Nyquist limit. Here's a short clip from the movie.
Of how aliasing works, let's watch a high-speed version of what we just went through.
In this video, you should have learned that nonlinearities which are not symmetrical around zero produce both odd and even harmonics. Nonlinearities which are symmetrical around zero produce only odd harmonics. Symmetrical clipping will produce no even harmonics if you use an accurate enough instrument. Aliasing can be used to see beyond the Nyquist limit. But more importantly, you learned how to question and disprove faulty assumptions and incorrect, outdated rules. Those rules get propagated through books like this and by professors who continue to teach them. And finally, you have learned that the audio testing Bible is wrong, and is probably wrong because the author could not test his theories and get the right answer because he used low-precision instruments. When people rely on faulty textbooks and archaic equipment, they often end up in trouble. The American novelist, humorist, and satirist Mark Twain knew about this kind of trouble. He once said, "It ain't what you don't know that will get you into trouble. It's what you know for sure that just ain't so." Many times I have seen engineers fighting problems that they should be able to solve if they just didn't rely on false information that they read or heard somewhere. The solution, of course, is to be prepared to discard old theories based on dated, archaic equipment and keep your mind open to new ideas and concepts. This video was brought to you by Applicos and Danceflix.